yeah, I'm damn sure gonna need something to drink after what the hell I just had to sit through. PlayStation, I got a quick question for you guys. Seeing that this is your first showcase in over 2 years, why did you decide to go out of your way to bore the living shit out of me? That felt like a chore to sit through. That. And of course, I'm referring to the PlayStation showcase that just transpired. I'm literally recording this 5 minutes after it just went off. It just ended like 5 minutes ago. That felt like a chore to sit through. Honest to God, I felt myself dozing off a few times. It was that boring. I don't get it with you. I don't fucking get it with you, Sony. You haven't had a showcase like this in over 2 years. You announce this, everybody gets their hopes up, including myself, yet again, and I really need to stop fucking doing that. I go in with a bit of optimism, a bit of hope that you're gonna knock it out of the park. Your first really big showcase in over 2 years. Probably since you announced the PlayStation 5. So I'm thinking, okay, you gotta knock it out of the park here. You gotta, hit grand slams. Not home runs, grand slams. And outside of maybe two grand slams, this showcase fucking sucked. What a waste of time for me. What a waste of time for everybody else. This is one of the reasons why I bought an Xbox. It's because I have been embarrassed by you as a company for far too long. I am so sick and tired of you getting my hopes up and then crushing them into just nothing but fucking dust. It's like when Thanos snaps his finger and everybody just turns into dust. That's basically what you just did to my hope right then and there. You just snapped your fingers and it just evaporated just like that. If I could snap my fingers, of course. What a waste of time. There was a few cool things you announced. You had started off with Helldivers 2. Okay, that's cool and all. I never played the first Helldivers, but I heard it was a really good game. Excuse me. Shout out to the Helldivers fan base. Hope you guys and gals have fun with Helldivers 2. Then we just basically had a whole bunch of indie games. A few of them looked all right, though, but most of them were just stuff I don't fucking care about. We had a Phantom Blade trailer for Phantom Blade Zero. That looked pretty damn cool. That actually woke me up a bit because, when I first saw it, I was thinking, "Oh, what the hell is this? Ghost of Tsushima 2?" At first, I thought it was that one game, Rise of the Ronin, but it wasn't. It turned out to be, like I said, Phantom Blade Zero. It looked pretty darn cool. I might check it out if it comes to PlayStation 4. I might check it out. If it's PS5 only, then obviously I'm not going to be able to check it out. I didn't even look to see if it was on PlayStation 4. I was, dozing off like every now and again during the showcase. It was so fucking boring. You showed off a game by Giant Squid, the makers of Journey and Abzu. And they basically combine Journey and Abzu together in one world with surfing, so that looks pretty damn cool. Until you announce that it's a PlayStation 5 only game, and it's like, oh well, there goes all my fucking hype for that game. I'm not gonna be able to play it because it's PlayStation 5 only. The only really big things that you announced in the showcase to me are, I guess, technically Final Fantasy 16, which is coming out next month. And I had to look away from the trailer when you showed it because I don't want to be spoiled on this game. Because Square Enix, they seem to be masters of basically giving the story away of their games in the gameplay trailers, and I fucking hate that about them. So I had to look away from that trailer. I really don't want to be spoiled on that game. I know it's a PlayStation 5 only game, but I really don't want to be spoiled on it. I did hear that the purple panda that I'm clipping, Shio, I heard that she might do a playthrough of it. I don't know. Maybe I'll watch. I mean, if I know if I do, I'm damn sure gonna 100% spoil myself on everything that happens in the game. But it's my decision if I watch or not. I don't know. We'll see. I did look away from the trailer though, 'cause I don't want to be spoiled on that game right now. And the other two announcements that really caught my attention were Metal Gear Solid. So the rumor is true. They are remaking Metal Gear Solid 3, and not only that, but they're bringing the Metal Gear Solid HD Collection to PlayStation 5. I didn't see anything about PlayStation 4, which really fucking pisses me off, because I really want to play the original Metal Gear games. I may hate Konami as a video game company, but I've always wanted to try out the Metal Gear Solid games, because I've never played Metal Gear Solid. They're bringing Metal Gear Solid, the PlayStation 1 version, Metal Gear Solid 2, and Metal Gear Solid 3, all the PlayStation 5 via the HD collection. I'm hoping that it'll be on PlayStation 4. If not 3, if not the remake of 3, at least Metal Gear Solid 1 and 2. Please let me play those on PlayStation 4. If not, I guess the only other hope I have is they bring it back to the Xbox via the digital storefront. Because you actually can play Metal Gear Solid 2 and 3 on Xbox, but you have to have a physical copy, and I don't have $50 lying around to buy a physical copy of that. So thanks for that, Konami. I'm really hoping that those games come to PS4. If not, I'm hoping you put the games back up on the Xbox storefront so I could buy them. Because those are games I actually would be willing to buy. I may hate you as a company, but I really would want to play those games. Anyways, outside of that, then of course there was Spider-Man 2, which they closed the showcase with. It was cool to see Spider-Man 2. I knew we were going to see it, and they actually showed off gameplay, which the gameplay looked really damn impressive. I am very interested in Spider-Man 2. Although it's only going to be on the PlayStation 5. And they pretty much confirmed that it's PlayStation 5 only, no PS4, unfortunately. I mean, from the gameplay itself, I knew it was going to be PS5 only. The way it looked, the twitching and stuff between characters, I knew, yeah, this is definitely PS5 only. They're basically implementing Grand Theft Auto V's character twitch feature into this game. You're going to be able to play as Venom, Miles, and Peter. For some strange reason, they didn't show off Peter in the gameplay, which I thought was a little odd. They only showed Venom or Symbiotic. I can't say that fucking word. I'm so sorry. You know which Spider-Man I'm talking about. The black suit Spider-Man, Venom basically. They showed off Venom. They showed off Miles. No Peter, which, like I said, was really odd. I mean, he's in the game. He was in the teaser trailer when they first announced the game, so he's in the game, but they didn't show him off here, which I thought was a little odd. Like, we know he's there. Where the hell is he? Nonetheless, they showed off gameplay of it. It's coming out fall 2023. When exactly in the fall, we don't know, but it's definitely coming out this year. No Final Fantasy VII Remake Part 2 news. No Last of Us Part 2 multiplayer. No Horizon Zero Dawn remake, which thank God, I'm glad you didn't announce that because I would have fucking died laughing if you would have announced that. And outside of that, this showcase was just a complete waste of time. Like I said, I was dozing off a few times. I didn't fall asleep. Like, I didn't f fully fall asleep, but I was dozing off. And when PlayStation does something like that to where they make me doze off, because I've done it during State of Plays, I've actually fell asleep during State of Plays before because of how boring they were. There was one State of Play where it was just all nothing but like shitty indie games. And no disrespect to indie companies, to indie games, I know they're trying to make ends meet, but if your games are not going to impress me and they're making me fall asleep watching them, I'm not going to feel invested to actually take my time out to go and buy your games and play them. Just saying. What a fucking disappointment. Outside of a few things, this was a colossal disappointment. First major showcase for PlayStation in over 2 years, and they give us that. Like, we couldn't even get any Final Fantasy VII Remake Part 2 news. We all know that's coming out supposedly at the end of the year. Yeah, we got Final Fantasy 16, but there's another Final Fantasy coming out, and ever since it was announced, not a fucking peep from Square Enix. Not a single peep. I get they're promoting Final Fantasy 16, that's understandable, because that's about to come out, but you also have another Final Fantasy game you're working on. Where the hell is it? Why has that there been any talk of it? Why hasn't there been any gameplay shown of it? What the hell is going on with it? Like I said, no Last of Us multiplayer. What the hell is going on with that? The game's been out for 3 years. And you mean to tell me that you still don't have this fucking multiplayer worked out? Are you kidding me? And worst of all, this is how fucking lazy PlayStation gets with their showcases. You show off a movie trailer for Gran Turismo. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck about Gran Turismo the movie. I care about the game. This is a game showcase. This is a PlayStation video game, keywords, video game showcase. Why are you showing movie trailers in a video game showcase? You shit on Xbox 10 years ago for the Xbox One reveal where it was TV television, TV television, TV television, TV television, but yet here you are showing a trailer for Gran Turismo. If you were gonna go show any movie trailer at all, which you shouldn't have, but if you were gonna show any trailer at all, why not show a trailer for Spider-Verse 2? That's coming out next week. You could have showed Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse 2 or Across the Spider-Verse 2, which then would lead into showing gameplay of Spider-Man 2. I would still shit on you for doing that, but not as hard as I am with Gran Turismo. Was this really fucking necessary? Was this really necessary? You made people wait 2 fucking years for this showcase just to show them a trailer for a movie that outside of the Gran Turismo fan base, and even, I bet you even they don't fucking care. Nobody cares about this shit except for you. No one. Need I remind you the last time a video game racing franchise had a movie, Need for Speed? How'd that fucking turn out? Oh yeah, that movie with the drizzling shits. Personally, in my opinion, I think that movie should have came out in like 2004 or 2005 when Need for Speed was at the height of its popularity. Underground 1, Underground 2, That's when the movie should have came out. Not 10 years later, when Need for Speed is completely irrelevant. And now here you are doing it again with Gran Turismo. I'm surprised you didn't announce anything about Twisted Metal. I'm surprised you didn't show off the fucking trailer for Twisted Metal. I'm surprised you didn't announce a Twisted Metal remake, a Twisted Metal Black remake. It's been rumored. You didn't show anything Twisted Metal off, which caught me by surprise. Just what a fucking waste of time. This is exactly why I bought a fucking Xbox. I know people are gonna say, "Ooh, Xbox don't have no games." At least Xbox, usually most of the time, doesn't bore the piss out of me when it comes to their showcases, unlike Sony. What a f Again, what a waste of time. I'm getting pissed off just thinking about what I just had to sit through. I should have just waited until the showcase was over and just go scrolling through the trailers of every game just to see what I like and don't like. I might just do that next time instead of just waste an hour and a half of my time on this shit. And then Jim Ryan, "We want to deliver the best showcase possible to the PlayStation consumer fan base. We want to be the innovators in gaming." If this is your way of being innovators in gaming, sign me the fuck out. Innovators in what? Innovators in curing my insomnia? 'Cause you damn sure almost did a very good job at doing that. If I had to give this showcase a grade, 2 out of fucking 10. What a complete waste of time. Outside of a few indie games, outside of Phantom Blade, which looked pretty darn cool, I like Giant Squid as a studio. I still haven't played their games yet, but from what I've seen of them, their next game looks pretty damn cool. It's basically Journey and Abzu mixed together with surfing, so I wish them the best of luck on that, although it's going to be a PS5 only game, so I'm not going to be able to play that. You showed off Final Fantasy 16, which again I didn't pay attention to because I don't want to watch gameplay trailers of that because Square Enix basically lets it spoil the whole damn story of the game. Metal Gear Solid HD Collection, fantastic. I hope it comes to PlayStation 4, or at the very least, I hope it comes back to digital storefronts for Xbox. Although, knowing Konami, they're probably not going to do that. At least I got Metal Gear Solid 5. I got Metal Gear Solid 5, the Definitive Edition. I bought that for like $3.99 on a sale a long while ago. $4 for Metal Gear Solid 5. The whole DLC, everything, Ground Zero, Phantom Pain, everything, $3.99. That's a pretty damn good deal. I couldn't pass that up. I hate Konami as a video game company, but I really would like to play those Metal Gear Solid games, because I've never played Metal Gear Solid. I've never played a Metal Gear game, period. If these are PS5 only, then I guess that wait's just gonna continue, unfortunately, unless I play 5 one day. I really would like to play the originals first, but nonetheless. And Spider-Man 2. That's it. Oh, you also showed off a bunch of VR2 stuff. Resident Evil 4 supposedly is getting a VR update, a VR2 update. Okay, that's great. I hope it's a free upgrade. I hope you don't fucking make people pay again for Resident Evil 4. Because if you do that, that would be really, really, really scumbag behavior. Not by Sony, but by, well, yeah, by Sony and by Capcom. Because this is being developed for PlayStation VR 2. So it would be both of your guys' fault. I really hope this is a free upgrade, 'cause if you make people pay for Resident Evil 4 again after just paying $70, man. Only good thing that comes out of PlayStation VR 2 support for Resident Evil 4 is at least we're gonna get to see Ashley in VR. And I gotta admit, Resident Evil 4 Remake Ashley, while she may not have the boobs of the original Ashley, good God. Ashley in Resident Evil 4 Remake. Smash material. Full on smash material. I don't give a fuck. That's really, honestly, all I have to say about this showcase. 2 out of 10. What a complete waste of time. Maybe Xboxes will be better. They're doing theirs in June. Let's hope it's better than this. That's all I have to say. I'm out. Peace.
They will find through the flames, flames that run.